My name is Dr. Aliza, and today we'll be talking about the orthodontic tooth movement. You might be aware of the different kind of tooth movement from your previous knowledge, like in first year and third year. One is the eruptive tooth movement, in which the tooth erupts from its follicle and to the occlusal plane. So this is the movement of the tooth, which is because of the eruptive tooth movement in the root. The second tooth movement you might be aware of is the pathological tooth movement. That is because of the periodontal problems, and because of the periodontal problems, you could be observing the teeth will start moving from the original position to another position because of the periodontal problems, and the teeth start moving. And other kind of tooth movement that we are going to talk about today is the orthodontic tooth movement. What happens in the orthodontic tooth movement? You, as an operator, orthodontist, or a general practitioner, start applying forces on the teeth by some orthodontic gadgets, braces, wires, and many auxiliaries. And as the response to the orthodontic forces, the teeth start moving from one position to another position. For example, let's talk about this case. The case has presented to us with the malaligned teeth. And what we've done, we have aligned the teeth. So what actually happened? The teeth move from one position, which is the malaligned position of the teeth, and to the perfect position. As you see, the teeth are moving, but actually what is happening, the roots are moving within the bone. So that's why you see the apparent response that the crowns are moving. What happens when you start applying orthodontic tooth movement? The teeth, the root move within the bone by inflammation. And this, after the application of the orthodontic forces, it triggers inflammation, and as a result of inflammation, the bone starts resorbing from one aspect of the root to, and the bone starts forming on the other aspect of the root. That's how the teeth move. Another aspect of the orthodontic tooth movement is that the attachment operators move along with the root. So if the root move from one position to another position, all the attachment operators around the root move along with the root. That you can see in this patient as well. For example, if you see this patient has presented to us with a gummy smile. And what we have done in this patient, we have done the intrusion of the incisors. So as you see the intrusion of the incisors, attachment operators, just like the gums and the bone around the tooth, has moved apically as well as the result of the orthodontic tooth movement. So before we dive into the full details of the orthodontic tooth movement, let's have a quick review of the normal anatomy and physiology of the periodontal ligament. As you know, the periodontal ligament is like a connective tissue, and all the connective tissue are having the blood vessels, nerve vessels, different kind of cells, and different kind of fibers, and some extracellular matrix. Exactly in a similar way, the periodontal ligament contain all of these things. So talking about the cells, we have different kind of cells present in the periodontal ligament. You have bone on one side, so you could expect the osteoblast and osteoclast on the bone side that are required for the normal remodeling of the bone. On the other side is the cementum, and because of the cementum, you could expect the cementoblast as well as multinucleated cementoclast. So you have cementoblast, cementoclast on due to the cementum over this that are required for remodeling, and you could be observing the osteoblast and osteoclast on the other aspect because of the bone around it. And what else you could expect? The fibroblast, because you see a lot of fibers in the periodontal ligament. So you would be having fibroblast, and here it's important to note down that the same cells which are responsible for making fibers are involved in the degradation of the fibers as well. So the fibroblast do the same job. They form the fibers and they degrade the fiber. So what kind of cells you can expect? Undifferentiated mesenchymal cells. From these undifferentiated mesenchymal cells, the different kind of cells originate that are the osteoblast, osteoclast, cementoblast, cementoclast, and the fibroblast. Along with this, you could expect the different kind of fibers that are mainly the collagen fiber and the elastic fibers as well. You could be observing, you could have the fluid, extracellular fluid in between the cells. And moving on to the normal functionality, what happens when we apply some heavy forces, like just like chewing, when we chew some hard stuff, what happens? Okay, if the force is for the very small duration, just like for less than 1 second, in this small period of the time, the fluid does not extrude from the periodontal ligament space, and as the result of the application of the force, what happened? The force is transferred through the periodontal ligament and the fluid to the adjacent alveolar bone and to the lamina dura. So the lamina dura or the alveolar bone bend on the application of the heavy forces if the force is very small duration, less than 1 second. But if the force is of slightly larger duration, like 1 to 2 seconds, in the 1 to 2 seconds of the forces, the fluid start extruding from the periodontal ligament space and express out from the PDL space, and the tooth move in the PDL space within the 1 to 2 seconds. Okay, so the tooth has moved from this position into another position as the space has been generated by the extrusion of the fluid out of this. But if the force keep on applying for 3 to 5 seconds, what happened? This you start feeling pain, because with this time period, the nerve ending, which are normally the unmyelinated endings of the nerves, they start being crushing and pressing. So as a result, you start feeling pain if the pressure is more than 3 to 5 seconds. Moving on, there is an important concept of the active stabilization. Active stabilization means that the periodontal ligament, due to its metabolic activities, keep the tooth in that particular position. First of all, we need to be aware of this, that with the previous knowledge, you would be knowing that the teeth are in the balance and they are in the equilibrium zone. But if you go into the very fine details, you are not having 100% perfect balance on the both sides, on the lingual, on the palate, or the lingual and the buccal aspect. There is a slight difference in the amount of the forces. Okay, so the difference, even despite of having the small difference in the amount of the force on the buccal or in the lingual aspect, the teeth keep on its original position. For example, you can see over here, 10 gram force is being applied from the lingual aspect and 5 gram force is being applied from the labial aspect. There is a difference of 5 gram of force. Even then, having this difference of 5 grams, the teeth is stabilized in this particular position because of the active metabolic activity of the periodontal ligament. So this established the biological basis for orthodontic tooth movement. If the teeth are actively stabilized, and this explains why the teeth are unstable in the imbalance pressure, and your force has to be greater than this threshold in order to move the bone. What actually you have to do? You have to actually activate the inflammation, and you have to activate the osteoclast cells. So you have to have a certain threshold of the force. You have to apply more than this level of the force in order to trigger and activate this orthodontic tooth movement, and it has to be greater than the active stabilization of the tooth.